Hey everybody, Hat Creature here. So, today I am not doing a viewer build. I was commissioned or suggested or asked to create an Infectious Nicholai build with just guns. And so I did. Whether it's viable or not, I don't know. But they said just guns, infection, and I'm like, okay, cool. I haven't made an Infectious Nicholai build that I'm comfortable with using bioterrorism. I did make an Infectious Nicholai build before bioterrorism existed, and I think that was a good build, but I have yet to find one that I've made that where I actually enjoy bioterrorism. It's cool, I just think it'd be better if it wasn't on this slot, because the problem is the economy. You take away the economy. So what did I come up with? I came up with extermination. No real reason, other than it's awesome. Blood trail, so when I do damage, they get tracked. This helps nemesis do more damage. Bioterrorism, of course, all my firearms cause infection. Auto shield mod, I think this was a suggestion, because SkiffyKnives, thank you. I love it when I see you. SkiffyKnives, I was the one who suggested, hey, have you done this? And they actually gave me the build that they use. When they do that type of build, I think this is one of the cards they gave me. I think I might be thinking of Will I Really Am's build, because after this, I'm doing some builds by Will I Really Am, and this may be in his build. That may be where I'm getting this from. I don't remember. But anyway, I have the auto shield mod. I need all the help I can get, to be honest. Since the economy is really bad, I think it would be beneficial to have the auto shield mod, since it's an infection build and. Well, yeah, I think this would really help. We have the reinforced leg hold trap, which costs 4. And, yeah. I'm not using this, because it's irrelevant with the auto shield. These are expensive. This would be really good, but it's too expensive. So I have this. It's cheaper. For equipment, I came up with Viral Canister 3, Modified Gear 2, which complements the pure gun build, because if you are doing pure guns, you need Modified Gear 2. Once they realize you don't have creatures, it becomes all too easy to counter you. And that's why we have this and the auto shield mode. I have Large Caliber Barrel 3, so my guns do more damage. Longlink 42 was saying that not only does Viral Canister 3 increase infection rate, but the damage your guns do increase infection rate. I've tried to test this on multiple occasions, but I can only test it in practice mode, so I don't know if the damage does it too. Because whenever I try to test the extra damage in practice mode, other survivors just die, and they don't get infected because they're dead. So I don't know if that's actually true. So I'm just I'm just going with Lawling saying it's true. So that's cool. That's awesome. Double infection. I have unstable generator for biocore durability and bioenergy recharge speed to help with the economy. And this is what I came up with the deck. Only one mod until area 2. That helps out energy booster firearms. I'm finally using it. I don't think I've made a deck where I've actually used this. It's a good card, but you don't really need it unless you're doing something like this. We have the machine gun, which costs 3. Air cannon costs 2. High caliber rifle costs 3. Deception, all my cameras look like them on them. Immobilizing rounds cost 2. Decoy trap, this will help the reinforced leg hold trap in area 3. If they think all my traps are fakes, they'll just walk right into it. Clone, for no real reason. Rifle, it costs 1. And energy booster firearms. So any guns in my hand will be decreased by, I think, 2 when I use this card. It's not like discount. The cards have to be in my hand when I use this. That's why this stops becoming that good in area 2, because the auto shield mod. Maybe I should replace it with radar pulse. Then I can always use this, but then I might need a shield. So maybe I should put in shield instead. Yeah, maybe that's the right choice. So that way I have a cycle card, and this will always be relevant. I can always choose this. Yeah. And then I still have this, So they don't know what camera I'm on. And then I have decoy. They think all my traps are fake. I can still pop out my guns really fast. I just can't repair my cameras really fast. That's the only thing. So I don't have the edge of always being on the camera. That's kind of why I got the auto shield mod. So maybe I should get it? So this costs 3. Once I pop this out, this will cost 1. Yeah. Same thing with this. So I guess, because what happens in Area 2 when I have 2 mods, I can only use this on 1 card instead of 2 cards. Yeah. So I guess I would only be using 1 card at a time, and then when I get to the machine gun or the high caliber, then I click this, and then I can use these. That's why I have clone. Because the problem is, since I'm using the auto shield mod, I have 2 things that aren't guns. So, yeah, you know what? I'm sticking with this. I'm sticking with the build. Auto shield. Yeah, I'm sticking with this. That's the gameplay. I'm only going to be playing 1 card at a time in Area 2 and 3 until I have this gun or this gun, then I'm using this. And that actually means I can use this if I want to. So this is 5 right now, and the energy booster, it turns into a 3. Yeah, so I could use this if I wanted to. But if I don't have energy booster, then this is too expensive. I'm gonna stick with what I got. Yeah, this went on for way too long. But anyway, yeah, this is my build. Also, I got an awesome comment. So the blinding effect from Masterminds and Survivors, it's really bright, it really hurts my eyes, so I was told, like, hey, you can just lower your brightness. So I lowered the brightness of the game. If the game is too dark when you watch this, and you cannot see what is going on, please let me know so I can turn the brightness back up. I'm just doing this as a test. You know, maybe it's too dark for me. I don't know. But we'll find out. Okay, so, this is the second time I tried to record this. The first match I did, I was actually AFK for half the match. And I lost because I was AFK. After reviewing, like, what happened in the AFK match, I decided to keep everything I have, because even though they were very disrespectful, going over the things that they did in that AFK match that I didn't show you, they still only left with 3 minutes in Area 3. So they started out with 8 minutes in Area 3, but by the end, even after they pulled the trigger to open the door, they only had 3 minutes left. And that's because I was AFK in Area 1 and 2 with this build. So, I think I actually would have beaten that shitty team had I been there. But because of that shitty team, because of how disrespectful they were, just very mean people. Why aren't people just nice? Because of that, I will not be talking in this video. I'll be talking at the end of the match. I hope you understand. I don't like, you know, I don't like being angry.
I provide great assurances to my clients.
So, let's just see how it goes.
And you will die. Put a bullet in your skull. It will be over faster.
Hacking.
You cannot run away so easily.
Thank you.
You can move to the more thing if you want job done. You must yourself do it. Yes? My God, the weapon!
You're gonna love this. Disabling the camera could be worse, I guess.
Now I shall end this. So many made it this far. It's unacceptable. Not a problem for me. Run, run if you can. My patience. Get it over with. Stop resisting.
The door's locked.
Parasite analysis. Virus in you. Dead walking. Strange world we live in. Strange, but profitable. If I too long, you lose, I get paid.
GG. GG.
You can die here just as easy as next place. Why do they pay a kitten to kill you?
Too late, Tyrone. Too late. Good attempt, but, well, no, I don't have any criticism.
Bonus.
It was a good attempt.
But a win is a win.
Yeah, I don't know what to say about Tyrone. I think he did all he could. I kind of had a feeling he had that ability to get back up, but I jumped out anyway because, the time was so low, why not? You know, I was going to win anyway, so I was like, hey, if he has it, I'll let him have it. That's why I did that. Also, I screwed up. I accidentally got rid of the large generator mod because I thought Nemesis was ready. I thought I could use Nemesis, so I just went over there and clicked the button, not knowing I didn't click Nemesis. So that's what that was. Let's go get a cosmetic. So yeah, that team that I didn't show you, because I was AFK. Yeah. The team in the AFK, they were shooting my cameras when I was not there. So I was not there in Area 1 or 2, but they were destroying my cameras anyway. Not the camera I was on, but the cameras at the security devices, the cameras at the keys. They were destroying them anyway, so they were wasting ammo. So that's why I'm confident that even though the other team that I didn't show you were hot on cams, I still think I would have beat them just because of how much time they had at the end of Area 3. Is this a good build? I don't know. Oh, that's interesting. Isn't there another one where they're crying? It's that one, but they're laughing. Oh, okay. This is the actual distraught one. So, yeah. What are your thoughts on the build so far? As far as infection goes, I don't know. It was really short, so I guess I'll play another match. But it's interesting so far. You know, it's just guns with infection. That's all it is. Auto shield mod is definitely good in this scenario because, because even if I don't have the energy to consistently attack with the auto shield mod, I still have the ability to do it. So even if I can't keep it up because I don't have the bioenergy, I can still at least slow them down. Having three effect cards and clone kinda hurts me with auto shield mod, but I don't know what I would pick. I don't know what I would switch out. Like, I don't have any other guns. I can probably use this or that, but then I'll have three things that cost three, and that's too expensive. So maybe I should choose this as a cycle card. I don't know. That might be a good idea. But I like the idea of having a trap there, because the trap helps with the reinforced leg hold trap in Area 3. Anyway, yeah. Yeah, let me know about your thoughts on me not talking during the match. I know that, my personality is the reason people watch me. I totally get that. But I don't like calling people trash all the time. You know, I don't want to be negative. And I still want you to enjoy my personality. So yeah, here's another match, I think. Okay, we have a whole bunch of stuff going on. Very interesting. I've seen Dan Oakenshield before. I don't remember if they're an asshole or not, but they're playing January. We have a low-level Martine, but that means nothing. We have a Sam and a Valerie. Valerie will help out. I don't know what kind of Martin it is. Don't know what kind of January we have. We're on research facility, so I'm not happy about that. But, I have auto shields, so that kind of helps. Okay, I am going to show you the match where I was AFK, but I'll be commentating over it. I talked in this one, but I turned down the volume. So anyway, high-ranked team, kind of. The Martin is a rank 16, but it doesn't matter. They're all disrespectful. They're all bad people. So I got interrupted here. I had a guest, like right after I popped out my first gun. I was hoping I could lock this door over here, but the cooldown was too high, so I couldn't do it in time, and Sam was coming out. So I was like, okay, I better turn off the light, get ready with my gun, and then I have a guest. So I'm like, well, shit. I don't want them abusing my camera, so I pop out. I walk away. So, I actually don't know how much time they had going into Area 2, so I guess I'll kind of skip over the... Oh, wait. Okay, so they're going into Area 2 with 6 minutes and 23 seconds. January breaks my camera because she's a bitch. Didn't even see if I was AFK or not. She just did it because she doesn't respect anybody. So I finally show up, way later, and I'm like, ah, shit, oh well. You see that? They thought I was AFK, and they still tried to destroy the camera. They thought I was AFK and tried to destroy it anyway. They were intentionally being paranoid and chose to waste ammo, choosing to be inefficient against someone that they currently thought was AFK. Now, I'm not going to, you know, repeatedly say that they were disrespectful. You can see that on your own. That's not what this is about. So they're coming into Area 3 with 8 minutes and 11 seconds. So this is the only time I actually get to really test out the build. And I do actually down them on multiple occasions. Okay, January right here. So they... January used her ultimate ability and locked me from using the elevator. But she did it too early. They're not even out the door yet. So they stopped me from using it early. And then my ability comes back. And now they come out. So all she did by using her ability was delay me raising the elevator. I raised the elevator the moment they walked out the door. Meaning she screwed over her team by not letting me raise the elevator early. That was a bad choice. That was really fucking stupid. And so I'm over here, you know, I'm trying to do all I can. They didn't fall for any of my traps because I hadn't been playing. So every trap they thought was a real trap. But, you know, that just shows, like, you know, the strength of the build if I could have kept going. Because they kept shooting all my traps. Even if they were decoys, they didn't know. So that means that the build helps them waste ammo. And over here, you know, they're cocky. But, oh, right here, Martin. Everybody was telling him not to go outside. Everybody was telling him not to go outside. And he did it anyway. I don't know, you know, how experienced he is in the game. He might not be, you know, he's a rank 16 Martin, but he might be a high level somebody else. But he's still disrespectful. But anyway, Sam gets up. I didn't even know that he wasn't in the safe room. So when I saw him on the elevator, I was like, wow. So I'm over here, I'm trying to infect him. And, you know, they're at 6 minutes. And that was partially their fault, that they're at 6 minutes right now. Because they wouldn't let me raise the elevator. And, you know, instead of shooting my camera, he's shooting the decoy trap. And then he gives up. Nice. You know, he's not even trying to face me, he's choosing the camera. And then I switch. And then I take him down. Because he was infected. He couldn't run away. And then, you know, I'm just trying to waste time. I'm not sure why my shots aren't stunning Valerie. I think if you're getting shot in the back, you should get stunned. But she wasn't getting stunned. That's the only time I've ever actually, like, noticed that you wouldn't get stunned. Like, it stuns you from using a security device, but it doesn't stun you from shooting. But at other times it does. It's very inconsistent. So I couldn't get her with the grenade launcher because there's no splash damage. And it may have just been too far away. But anyway, they get this second biocore because there's not really much I can do here. They're at 5 minutes, they're at the second biocore. They're waiting for each other. Despite having 5 minutes on the clock and me barely being able to play, they still wasted time and chose to wait for each other. When all they could have done was just blow out the camera, because there's only one camera at that biocore. Didn't have to waste time. Did it anyway. But I walk away and I stop trying because, you know, January's on the camera. You know, I can't do it. There's only one camera. So I walk away and I'm like, okay, last biocore, what can I do? I place a trap because I know they're shooting traps. And I'm just trying to cycle cards. And they lower the elevator. And I do get somebody with the goop. I just don't remember who. Yeah. There it is. Ah. I couldn't get the shot in time. And then I pop out Nemesis. And then, you know, I'm doing all I can. They killed my liquor. And I timed that rocket launcher. I was punching first to bait the flash. And then I got Martin to fall in my trap. Valerie over here, you know, she is trying to kill me. You know, if she can do it, then she should try. I don't think anybody should actually try, though, because it's not fair for the mastermind right now. It's just kind of, like, mean, because Neobards didn't optimize, whole killing the bioweapon. It's just not fair for the mastermind. They didn't die here because of the yellow herb. So, the yellow herb kind of counteracted my extra damage. Close range. That's actually pretty impressive. And I get a tentacle attack here. Like, at the last second. Like, I actually got it right there. That was badass. So they're at 3 minutes and, you know, seconds right now. Last biocore. So I'm doing what I can, and I kind of... I do good here, but I kind of screw up later. Like, right here. There's the flash. And I can't get the last biocore. So I have clone in my deck, right? So... I forget that that gun is clone, and then I choose the energy booster thinking it's a gun, so I kind of fucked up. I didn't know that was clone. And then I shoot this thinking that they were going to come out, but it was too early, and I couldn't really see the elevator. Also, check this out. They're going to run directly underneath my camera, and I can't do anything about it. Awesome. Great design. So, they pulled the trigger, they have 4 minutes. At 4 minutes, that's with pulling the trigger. I'm confident that because of the choices that these survivors made, if I was able to, you know, play the entire time, I actually think I would have won. Because they're trying to leave, but they're at 4 minutes. And this is with me being AFK in Area 1 and 2. They came in with 8 minutes, they left with 4. So, I took off half the time they came in with. You know, 8 minutes and 11 seconds. Due to their choices and, you know, my build and my gameplay. Would I have won if I had actually played through Area 1 and 2? I don't know, but I think I would have just because I took off half their time in Area 3. Yeah. I'm not trying to be nitpicky with some of their choices, but everything, every choice you make is important. You know, choosing to waste ammo when you know no one's there. You know, shooting at shadows. That's a bad design choice. Using your ultimate, and then your ultimate screwing you over. And she's level 60. She should know what she's doing. Martin, he may not actually be a low level. Getting himself killed. Samuel, shooting a trap instead of shooting a gun that's shooting back at him. Yeah. It's those little things and the time that make me feel I could have won. But anyway, let me know your thoughts. You saw the match where I won, and then you see this match where I lost because I was AFK. So let me know your thoughts. I am curious. You know, they were bad people, but I also think that maybe they were bad players as well. So, yeah. I kind of go on a rant here. The video is pretty long. I kind of go on a rant because I'm basically saying, you know, why can't people be nice? yeah. You know, why can't people be nice? Come on, man. Why can't people be nice? Anyway, thank you everybody for watching. Let me know your thoughts. And as always... have a great day, and don't be a fucking asshole. Thank you.